Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Once again, we are here on our 32nd Master's Training Series. And we still have another 8 series to finish the 40 series of this Master's Training. And again, I would like to welcome everybody on our training, and just want to give you an update on Dr. Fabunan's antiviral injection. Hello, Amba George. I know you knew something about Dr. Fabunan's antiviral injection. And we are praying that FDA primarily and the government will approve of this so that it can help COVID victims, especially those who are COVID positive. Hallelujah. We needed this kind of mind, the inventors, so that Filipinos will not depend on other countries anymore. And as God has provided us with a great mind like Dr. Fabunan. I remember when Amba Roy cannot really walk because of his gout. Because of his gout, the thing that they have done, and they went to Dr. Fabunan's clinic in San Marcelino. Hello, Sister Dasha and Sister Margie. And they went to Dr. Fabunan's clinic and receive that antiviral injection. You know what? After the injection, the pain in the feet of Amba Roy suddenly gone. Yesterday, I was listening on the report of Dr. Fabunan. They are all of the brothers and see all of the siblings are professionals, and there are about 4 or 5 of them who are all physicians. Others are lawyers, others are CPA. Hallelujah. So they are really into the health service, and they really studied about this, and they have a list of these viruses in them. As one of the doctors is also a medical technologist, and in the list, in their list, included in their list is the coronavirus. So before, they have already idea about the virus, and they really know what to do. Hello, Engineer Bay, welcome once again, and let's pray that that the Holy Spirit will take control of the Food and Drug Administration and give the approval to Fabunan's antiviral injection. We needed this one. Hello, Engineer Edison Castro. It's been a long time. Welcome. Thank you. Welcome, Saipan. Tagal na tayo nagkikita. Mahigit isang dekada na. How's your family, General Edison? Okay? So, let's pray. Let's decree that God will eventually address this thing.
Peter?
Huh?
Peter?
Huh? Huh? Unless you search it. Okay? So, let's pray about that. And if this, I'm not going to say if, and this will happen, Philippines will be the one who will provide the real help, the help that this pandemic brought to the whole world. So please declare the words with me that the Holy Spirit will give, will grant, will grant them the FDA's approval. ASAP. Hello, Sister Francine. Okay? So this afternoon, forgive me if I cannot speak that clear, because yesterday I have the pain here, and still the pain is getting more. Hallelujah. I can feel the pain. I can really feel the pain, and I cannot speak that clear because of this pain. Hello, Pastor Ernie. Hello, Amba Medel. But we will continue our study. Just bear with me. Bear with me. I will speak as much as I can, as clear as I can. And I decree that pain that will be get out in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Okay. So, this afternoon, we will be talking about the understanding, the pattern of the kingdom of God. Yesterday, I enjoyed our study with regards to dimensions. Okay? I enjoyed the study about dimension. For your information, I already posted the first 10 study on my YouTube channel. So please go to my YouTube channel and watch the first 10 series that I've brought here. And please subscribe, and of course pass also the teachings to others and let them subscribe, so that if I will have another other teachings that I will post, they'll get their notice about it. Okay, so get the teachings. It's in my YouTube channel, Jade Lelina 6. Hello, Pastor Ella and Amba Roger. Okay, so again, understanding the pattern of the kingdom of God. As I kept on telling you, the kingdom of God has a protocol. It has a protocol. The protocol is a strict system that everybody in the kingdom needs to follow. Everybody. You cannot invent something, though how biblical it is, if this is not aligned in the system of established protocol of God. Because every established protocol, as you can see, is always based on the character of God. Everything that God created, everything that God has given here on earth, everything is based on His character. Which is I kept on saying that everything that we have right now is not because of Jesus, but because of God. This is the mindset of God the Father. Okay, so in John 14 verse 23, it says Jesus replied, "If anyone loves me, he will obey my teaching. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him." This is such a powerful words coming from Jesus. that if you really love him, you will obey every teaching that he gives. And my. One of the teaching is in Matthew chapter 13. As he said, to you it's been given to understand the mysteries, the secrets of the kingdom of God, to them or not. If you are open to my teaching, look at those words in Matthew 13 verse 11. If you are open to my teaching, you'll be given knowledge. So, if you love the Lord, really, you will really obey His teaching. Hello, other one. You will really obey His teaching. And the result of obeying Jesus' teaching is this. The Father and the Son will make their home in you. So that's the result of us obeying the teaching of our Lord. And what is the teaching? We all know that the Lord has only one teaching that He gave us, and that is the gospel of the kingdom of God. Okay? It's the gospel of the kingdom of God. And every teaching that we have in the church is only a part of the gospel of the kingdom of God. Okay? And next, in 1 John chapter 3, verse 9, it says, no one who is born of God will continue to sin, because God's seed remains in him. He cannot go on sinning because he has been born of God. Hello, Pastor Rudy. So, if you are really obeying the teachings of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will not dwell on sin, because you have been born of God. And many believers, many followers of Jesus are continually sin. They continually sin. They struggle with sin. Hallelujah. They cannot go on sinning because they have been born of God. So, if you have been born of God, what does that mean? What does that mean? Hallelujah. This is so great to study, because I myself, I've been struggling with sin for almost 2 decades. Hallelujah. I don't want what I'm doing. I hate what I'm doing, but I've been doing it. I don't know why, but I'm struggling with it. And thank God, because I found the message of the kingdom that brought me freedom. Sakit. Masakit. Another verse. 1 John chapter 2, verse 24. See that when you have heard from the beginning, remains in you. If it does, you also will remain in the Son and in the Father. Hello, my sister. Hello, Pastor Ariel. See that when you have heard from the beginning, remains in you. If it does, you also will remain in the Son and in the Father. So what is that words, what are the things that remains in you? So if you receive a teaching that is of God, those teaching and even the power of the teaching will remain in you. It will remain in you. Okay? And if you receive a teaching that is not based on the truth of God's kingdom, whatever you do, you will keep on struggling with sin. And it's so great, so beautiful, that the life in the kingdom, we have not been talking about sin anymore, because our life is walking in righteousness, not sin. Unlike before, though you have lots of Bible studies, though you have lots of cell groups, though you are praying every day, reading the Bible, serving in the ministry, but you kept on doing sin. Okay? So, when you do sin, when you are doing sin, it only means that you are not under the government of God. Look at our problem right now. President Duterte said, if the people will not discipline themselves, because they've caught citizens of the Philippines here in Manila, that after they got their social amelioration fund, they immediately used that to buy drugs, to buy liquor, and to do their vices. Hello, Sister Cynthia. And it's not funny. It's a life of a fool that everybody has this problem. Their family have a problem. They don't know where they will get their food, and it's still they're using the fund from the government in doing their things. So the president says, if you will not discipline yourself, I will embark like a martial law. So that the soldiers and the police will be the one to hold everything. Because the COVID-19 issue is a real threat, and we still have about 12 days. Hello, Ambasincha. We still have 12 days. After this one, the lockdown will be through. Okay? So, these people, they are not submitting themselves to the government of Duterte. So, that's the life of a sinful citizen. Many of us is a citizen of the kingdom of God, but many have not given their full allegiance to the kingdom, and they are still doing their own life, which really helps them. So I will show you the types. Hello, Pastor Larry. The types of secular governments, okay? So, there are different types of government. Until we understand what types there are, we will not understand what type of government is going to come forth in the kingdom of God. So, there are lots of types of government on earth, okay? So, we have the Republican form of government. It's a Republican form of government. It is a state in which the sovereign resides in the people, or a certain portion of the people elected by the people to represent them. The United States is a republic. It is not a democracy. They elect officials to represent them. Next is democratic form of government. In its purest sense, it holds that all the people should. It holds a state in control. Each person has an equal share of prosperity and responsibility. It is obvious that the idea of democracy is good but unattainable. Next is absolutism, form of government. It masquerades under many names so that it doesn't always sound bad to the listeners. Offshoots of the form of absolutism are dictatorship, despot, autocracy. This form of government is the doctrine of unlimited authority and control. Generally, it is found in one individual. Next, totalitarian form of government. It is where one party suppresses all the other opposition. Some examples of that are found in World War I and II under the Nazis, the Fascists, and today, the Communists. Hello, Sister Elvi, good afternoon. Next is the feudal form. All the feudal form is not already present in our time, so it's still also a form of government. Hello, Pastor Leonardo. We find this in the time of Robin Hood. It was a political and social condemnation. The land was given to the people for their military service, And the people were called serfs or lord of the Lord of Master. Then we have the monarchical form of government. An absolute monarchy is where the ruler has a total authority. England had that for a while, but now it is a constitutional monarchy where the leader has limited authority by the law. Okay? Alam mo dyan. Okay, so those are the forms of government right now in the world. And every kind of government there is, every kind is failing. Even here in the Philippines, we have an economist who became a president, an artist, a soldier, what else? A mother, a son of a mother. Everybody, we have different kinds of a president who governs us, but everyone is a failure. Yes, even the government of President Duterte, he is doing everything that he can, unlike the other presidents, but still, this government is a failure also in its totality. Okay? Okay, we will discuss that later. So, President Duterte is doing everything, and the funny thing is this: I saw a video in Italy. Right now, they are in total lockdown, and if they see a citizen, thank you, unless they see, hello, Brother Lori, Sister Rosanne. Unless they see citizen who's roaming in the street, hallelujah, they really smite them with their all strength, and hallelujah. Their Italy is too late of what they have done. They have thousands and thousands of death already. Okay? So here in the Philippines, the president is asking, for consideration to the Filipinos to please stay on your home. Hello, Pastor Ben. Okay, so I will also let you see the different types of church government. Okay? There are actually three forms of church government: the Episcopal, Republican, and Democratic. The Episcopal, it is where the power comes from the top down. The bishops have the power, and they appoint the ministers who then rule the local church. You'll find this in Episcopal Methodist Church as a rule. And in every other religion as well, we will find this one. And you have the Republican form of government. The people, the church members, elect elders or presbyters that this run the church and also pick the pastor or minister. The elders rule the church for the benefit of the people. And we also have the democratic form of government. This is where everyone has an equal say in the direction of the church. The church as a whole votes on a minister coming, and the congregation is fairly autonomous. We generally find this structure in the Baptist organization, and in other, even in the full gospel, you can find this one. Evangelical, you can find this one, but they made a little change. Okay, now we will go to theocracy. What is theocracy? Hello, Bishop Hermie. God's form of government is theocracy. It means a God-run government. Some may say that God runs their church and sanctions their form of church government. Okay? That statement would be true. But whatever form of government it is, it will not be allowed in the kingdom. You know why? In the kingdom, it is totally run by God. Man has no say at all. Hello, Sister Jocelyn. You know what? during the time, during the early time of my study about the kingdom. It's like, what? How can that be? Diba, God is using men. So how can he rule without men? So it became a big question on me, how God will run theocracy in men. And thank you. And I thank God because he has given me the wisdom on these things. It's really not easy, but it's possible. It's possible. Okay, so let us see this. During the time of Prophet Samuel, under the Israelites had men king, they were being ruled directly by God. Okay? When the Israelites decided to be like other nations, rather than being a separate people as the Lord required, they sought to have a monarchy. God clearly states that the people didn't reject Samuel, but rejected him, God, as their head. Okay? One of the policies of the church movement today is the fact that they are trying to establish God's law and God's ways through the use of a form of government that man has established. They are trying to do something in their carnal, fleshly way that will never be established. Will never. We will never change man's government by using God's ways within it. Mahirap po yun. There is to be a totally new structure. And what is this? Before a government can be established, there has to be a people that not only see it with their inner eye, but also understands how to use it. The government starts with the people. Look at this. The government of the kingdom of God is coming and first must be allowed full reign within the hearts of believers in order that they might set it up on this earth. We cannot have a kingdom manifested in the natural until there are leaders prepared to set it up. That is the reason why we keep on sharing the message of the kingdom. The kingdom that we are sharing right now, it starts on our spirit. This is a spiritual kingdom. The physical kingdom that the theologians are mentioning will come. It will come soon. But that is not the gospel of the kingdom today. The gospel of the kingdom today, it speaks about us. As Jesus said, the kingdom of God is within you. It starts from you. It starts from us. So the kingdom of God needs to be established first in each one of us. God gave the kingdom in each one, not to a group. God has given the kingdom to each one. Hello, Pastor Sharon. Each one. Again, I say each one. So if everyone receive the government of God in their lives, this government will bring them order. Order. I cannot mention a second. This kingdom will give them order. Government means order. So if each person receives a kingdom, each one will receive an order, and this order will bring them into a unison of being one for the purpose of the government. Hello, Sister Beatrice from California. Okay? So, this is the difference. The church right now is talking about truth and doctrines that it speaks about their mind, what they need to do in the flesh and everything. But in the kingdom, God is talking to you, God inspiring you, God is transforming you from the inside. From the inside first. As the Bible says, first the spiritual. First the spiritual. We need to be catered by God in the spiritual first, before the flesh. Hello, Pastor Jabu. So, we don't need to work on the flesh, on what we see, because the kingdom is a spiritual one. Okay? It's spiritual one. The government that God intended to each one of us is a personal government. I also call this one as a personal leadership. A personal leadership. Hallelujah. You cannot lead others if you yourself cannot lead yourself to morality, to truth, to rightness. Many people right now are leading others because they have the capacity in their mind, in their position, and in their finances. That's the kind of leadership we have right now. But the leadership we have from God always starts from within. Remember, when you speak about leadership, you don't talk about leading people. Okay? It talks about you lead them to their potential. When you speak about leadership, you don't speak about leading them to follow you. No. Leadership speaks about you lead the people to their potential. That's what leadership in the kingdom is. Remember, the kingdom is always the purpose of God. It is the purpose of God in each one of us. So God trained us, God mentored us, God prepared us for others. Remember the book of the words of God in Joshua, when the Lord said to Joshua, "Joshua, be very strong and be very courageous, for you will lead these people to their promised land." Hallelujah. If you want to become a leader, let God train you. Let God prepare you. Let God mentor you. Not for yourself, but for others. But for others. And you know what? As you lead people, as you lead others to their potential, you will see how God will lead you to the greatness that He has for you. Okay? We cannot have a kingdom manifested in the natural until there are leaders prepared to set it up. Okay? So, spiritual is very, very important. Now, let's look at this. As we all know, the world kingdom means a territory, a people, a state, a realm, ruled by a king or a king ruling within a domain. He is the king ruling over a territory, which is what a kingdom means, a realm or area. The saints that are called the elect will be the ones serving him in positions of authority. But Jesus Christ will be the authority ruling through them. They themselves will not be ruling. Look at those powerful words. God set us up to serve Him, to serve His purpose. Which I always say, because I will say, our idea, our suggestion, our thoughts is nothing in the kingdom of God. God called us, God trained us, God mentored us, and prepared us for us to become His mouthpiece, His spokesman. So when you speak something apart from the heart of God, you will be recalled. You don't belong as the spokesman of God. Hallelujah. So in the kingdom, there's a strict formation that we need to understand. Okay, let's go to the next. The kingdom will not be established until the kingdom of God is established 100% in the hearts of every believer. Okay? The second that. It should be 100% in every believer. There is no sense in looking for an outward manifestation of the kingdom. Rather, we should be looking for the King to manifest himself totally within us. He must increase and we must decrease in order for believers to learn through divine government. Hello, Sister Connie. So, most of the preachers right now, they are always looking for the manifestation in the physical. Oh, that this government will release. No. The kingdom of God is specifically will release manifestation from the inside, not from the outside. Yes, there will be, all these things shall be added unto you. Yes, it can happen. But the things that we are talking is only a manifestation for you to use it for to reach others. Okay? But if you have the manifestation of things, but if you don't have the character to bring what is supposed to be delivered, even though whatever you have, the power of the Spirit will not manifest on those things. Yes, they will just be blessed on what you have given, but that's it. You know, everything that is physical is temporary. Once it's gone, it's gone. But everything that you have delivered in the Spirit, hallelujah, that has the permanence. It will bring the permanence. Hello, Brother Tomas. It will bring the permanence. Every spirit things is permanent. Permanent. I always remember, wherever I go and speak about the kingdom, I saw people who have been converted, who have been transformed, who have been changed because of the message. They've been calling me, they've been encouraged, they've been pushed. They really experienced something in their lives that they didn't experience even before. This is how the kingdom of God works. Remember the man? What is the name of the man who climbed the tree? What is his name? The man, the little man who climbed the tree. What is his name? Hallelujah. If anyone can answer that, I will send you banana cue. Hallelujah. I am full of things in my head. Hello, Barang. Welcome. Yes. Okay, Amba George, I will send you lots of banana cue. Okay? With banana on it. Remember the man Zacchaeus? When Zacchaeus experienced, yes, Zacchaeus. When Zacchaeus experienced the Lord didn't encourage him or told him things or prayed for him about something. No. The mere presence of the king in the life of Zacchaeus brought transformation in the life of Zacchaeus, that he said, okay, Lord, whomever I did this, I will return their money. I will do this. I will do this. Look at what the kingdom can do. It starts from the inside. And if you have the powerful presence of the king with you, you don't need anyone to lay their hands on you or prophesy on you, but the presence of the king will just bring you the wisdom, the power, and the righteousness you need so that you can become more than a blessing to other people. Hallelujah. It is, notice, It is only when a people are set apart, it is only when a people are set apart, as Israel was as a nation, that we can hope to see on earth a change of government. The kingdom is first spiritual and must first be allowed to rise within the people of God. It must be spiritual first. Do not look for the physical things, you know. When I experienced the physical, the kingdom of God, 34 years ago, 34, was this? 35 years ago, I was so blessed. I was so blessed materially and financially. Hallelujah. I was so blessed that I'm sending my people everywhere. Hallelujah. Until I go deeper. And the Lord let me focus on the deep things. On the deep things. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. As I go along on the deep things, I've experienced to receive revelations after revelations that I was amazed. I was amazed and I was old on the things that he's telling me. And I've never read those things on books. But he gave me these things to show me that I've requested those things from him. Remember when I asked the Lord, "Lord, can you please give me my own revelation of, regarding your kingdom, as you have also given to Dr. Miles?" Many people are blessed with Dr. Miles. I'm blessed with Dr. Miles. But here's the problem. Many kingdom people right now, they stayed with the revelation of Dr. Miles. Hallelujah. They stayed with it. They never go deeper from where Dr. Miles has set in. And actually, there are people who made the teaching of Dr. Miles as the gospel according to Dr. Miles Monroe. Hallelujah. They already made his teaching as another gospel. Hallelujah. Remember, in the things about the kingdom is a spiritual one. A spiritual one. And everything in the spiritual is progressive in nature. It never stays. Remember I taught you yesterday about dimension? God will not let you stay in one dimension. God loves you to go from dimension to another dimension, until he returns, you will experience glory to glory to glory to glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why I have seen, when I see a person speaking about the kingdom and I heard something like this, oh come on. This teaching came from Miles Monroe again. Hello Dave, how are you? Your family? Hello. And I was like, oh come on. Again, they just don't have the revelation. They're just repeating the same words that Dr. Miles has spoken. Maybe that's the reason why the Lord get Dr. Miles this early. Hello, Mike, your family. Hello. Maybe that's the reason. Because if God will not do that, oh hallelujah! Even in the church of Dr. Miles, there are only few of them, very very few of them, whom Dr. Miles discipled. But again, the revelation has never We'll go deeper. Hello, Pastor Ralph, from Alaska. Pero yung picture mo, Singapore yan, ha? And just like when Elijah was about to depart on earth, here came Elisha. And it is only Elisha who has that guts to say, give me a double portion. And Elijah says, that's a hard thing. That's a hard thing. You know what? When I prayed that before, as I started the kingdom last 18 years ago, I said, Lord, can you give me my own revelation about the kingdom of God? And when I prayed for that, hallelujah, I never expect that it will go that deeper. Hello, Brother Ralph and Geraldine from Singapore. I will never expect that I will go that deeper in the revelations. And I'm so excited because the kingdom has a lot of revelation. And right now, I am teaching people not to become preachers. I am teaching people to become ambassadors and to get their own revelation. This is the purpose of my trainings. The purpose of my trainings is not for the people to copy me. No. The purpose of my training is to help them see where they will get the revelation, how to get the revelation. And there are so much revelation that God can give us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you see, during the past 32 series, as we started this on last March 18, I have brought you a lot of revelations after revelations. And even right now, when the Israelite asked Samuel, Prophet Samuel, to have a king, Samuel was hurt. And the Lord told Samuel, Samuel, it is not you that they rejected, it's me. But in the inside, God is smiling. Why? Because the people, the Israelites right now, are looking for their king. God's design, a king that will rely on the King of Kings. Hallelujah. That is God's design. Hallelujah. And God loves it. God loves it when each one of us wants to move in the royalty of our design. When I say royalty of our design, hey, hello, Pastor Sam from San Pablo. When I say the royalty of our design, remember this. As in 1 Peter says, we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a peculiar people, a chosen generation, that we may show forth. Look, those four words, those four statements, royal priesthood, a chosen generation, peculiar people, a chosen nation, these are the four things that you need to have before you can bring praises to our King. You should have the four qualities so that you can bring praise to our King. These are not the statements that, oh, you are a chosen generation, God has like this, you are chosen people. No. These are God's. This is God, this is the King's demand. This is the King's demand for all of us to have it so that we can bring our praise to Him. Hallelujah. Okay, let's go to the next part. All during the history of the world, there has been a remnant conformed to the image of God. There will be enough of this remnant in this age that is closing to be leaven that will change the whole structure of the world. Remnants. When you speak about remnants, in Tagalog, that's called mumu. You know, in the food, those are crumbs. Yes, in English it's crumbs. This is the food, and this is the crumbs. The crumbs are the remnants. The crumbs are the remnants. Hallelujah. And the remnants are the matured sons of the kingdom. And there will be really a few, very few of this remnant whom God will release on this time. I'm preparing myself to deliver the word on April 26 about the new season. The new season that God is giving us. You know, every time there's a lockdown in the Bible, every time there's a lockdown in the Bible, during Moses' time, Noah's time, what else? Joshua's time. During those lockdowns, after the lockdowns, look what happens. There's always a new season, a fresh revelation that God gives to the remnants. And if you are not sensitive about being the remnant in the kingdom of God, you will not get the message. You will not really enjoy the message. For the next move will be a different move from the others. Yes, remnant chosen quality, not quantity. Yes. It's the coming perfection of God to His people. This time, the people, the remnants that will stand, they will stand opposing their family, their wife, their children, their work. They will not compromise what God has gave them. That is why you need to teach your children, your wife also, about becoming a remnant. Because you will be placed on a position where you will choose if you're going to serve God or serve your family or serve this or serve that. There'll be, hallelujah. God is going to bring out this remnant to demonstrate the power of His might. Yes, glory realms. Yes, thank you, Brother Val. Amen. So, right now, I'm going to show you the church age. It's what we call the church age. Okay? They're asking me, somebody asked me, is this the time of the end time or the birth pains? And I've told them, didn't you understand that birth pains or the end times is started when Jesus Christ declared it? The end times is started 2,000 years ago, not on this time. Remember, we have the problem during the World War I. Is that the end time? World War II. Is that the end time? And in the Roman conquering and those times, who were doing those things, is that the end time? Actually, the end time started 2,000 years ago. We are not in the end times. We are inside the end times, but we are not focusing ourselves on the end times, because you will see the wondrous work of God during these end times. During these end times, you will be a worker of miracles. You will be signs, wonders, and miracles following your life everywhere you go. There will be so much healing every time you preach the kingdom. God will manifest these things in you. Look at this. I'm not posting this yet. It says here, the last days has started 2,000 years ago. We are now in the days of the kings. These are the days of the kings. Hallelujah. We are now on the days of the kings. As Daniel chapter 2 verse 44 says, God is setting up a kingdom that cannot be shaken. This kingdom will destroy other kingdoms. This kingdom cannot be overcome. And this kingdom is eternal. We are on the days of the kings. Oh, you should be excited about this. Because God is including you. Is including you in these days of the kings where He is setting up His kingdom. The kingdom, the church that moves in the kingdom, the church that moves and operates in the principles of the kingdom, the church that moves and operates in the values of the kingdom, the church that moves and operates in the statutes and laws of the kingdom. This is the church that God will set up on the days of the king. The church actually is only mentioned once during the Gospels. And the point here is this. God is giving the kingdom to the church. The main focus of the kingdom is the church. And when Jesus said, "Upon this rock I will build my church," Jesus Christ is actually saying, upon the principles, the statutes, the values, the power, the culture of the kingdom, my church will become the real, the true church of God, which is you, I, and each one of us. The true church of God's, of the King, will be living on the culture, principle, values, power, and the movement of the kingdom. The church that we have right now, the church that is the church that moves in apostolic, the church that moves in prophetic, the church that moves in worship, the church right now moves in their specific calling, and they call prayer as a specific move from God. Hello, Sister Grace. And they call prophetic as a specific strength. And they call prosperity as a specific strength. And they call church growth as a specific strength. They didn't understand that if you are in the church, if the church is inside the kingdom of God, everything of those things are inside the church. This is the time, this is the season where the church will become a powerful church. I'm not talking of a corporate church. I'm talking about you. There will be a church, an individual person who has become a church based on the kingdom that will move and manifest the power and authority of the kingdom in his life. I'll be going to do that. I will manifest the power and authority of the kingdom in my life. I will move in these principles. I will never depart from it. Hallelujah. Yes, consecrated, peculiar, uncommon kings. Yes, that is what we are. That is what God will bring us to become. We are now in this season. God made the earth to rest. God made each one of us to rest. God has rested everything globally. Why? Because He wanted to talk to His kings. He wanted to talk to His remnants. He wants to talk with His matured sons. And you are that person. You need to be prepared. You need to be excited. You need to do something, because we are not a part of the church age anymore. Okay? We are not a part of the church age anymore. I will jump into this. Okay. I will show you the difference of the church and the kingdom of God. Okay? The difference of the church and the kingdom of God. Number one, here it is. The church has the gifts of the Spirit, while the kingdom produces life or the fruit of the Spirit, which is the very eternal nature of God. The church right now loves moving in the gifts. In the gifts, prophetic gifts, apostolic gifts, teaching gifts, healing gifts, they love the one. But in the kingdom, we produce life. And together, the fruit of the Holy Spirit, which will manifest in our life. Now the question, does the gift of the Spirit bad? No. Look at this. It's very different when you move with the gifts of the Spirit without the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Okay? It's very different when you move with the gifts of the Holy Spirit without the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Oh, that's very dangerous. There's a lot of church leaders today right now who are moving in that manner. They are moving in the gifts, but without the fruits. But without the fruit. They are moving with the gifts without the fruit. But in the kingdom of God, we are moving with the fruit and the gifts are following us. Okay? In the kingdom, we move with the fruit and the gifts are following us. Hello po, Brother Henry. Okay? So that's the difference. The church moves with the gifts without the fruit. In the kingdom, we move with the fruit and the gifts are following us. Okay? So that's the number one difference between a church and a kingdom. Yes, big difference. Really big difference. Okay? Number two. The church has a Levitical priesthood. It was a ritualistic, traditionalistic form of service. The minister hears for the people. The minister hears for the people. But the kingdom is a Melchizedek priesthood where man can go directly to God. Have you noticed that? Have you noticed that? Until right now, in many of the churches, they are always dependent on the pastor. Pastor, please pray for me. Pastor, what do you think God will do for me? Pastor. It's not bad. It's not. But it is not helping. It is not helping the congregation. It's not helping them. The congregation, the citizens are not growing. Because the center of everything is the pastors already. The kingdom is not. In the kingdom, we are teaching everybody to move in their giftings, to move in their design, to move in their assignment. Because each one of us, we have our specific, designated, allocated assignment and task from God. In the kingdom, it's not I'm much important than you. No. In the kingdom, we are all important. Whether your work is this, or this, or this, or this, it doesn't matter in the kingdom. Doesn't matter. The thing here is this. Every one of us has a designated assignment that we need to accomplish. Okay? Here's another thing. Number three. In the church, there is an abundance of grace. Grace covers a multitude of sin. It is because of easy grace that sin abounds among the church. But the kingdom is run by divine law. And grace is taken seriously for us to mature. Oh, hallelujah. That's what's happening in the church today. Listen. Because of the wrong, misleading understanding about grace, grace has become a ticket for people to do sin. Grace has become a permit, a pass for everyone to do something that is not aligned before God. Hallelujah. But in the kingdom, we recognize the statutes, the law of God. And grace is what gives us the strength to follow the laws and the statutes that is given us. Okay? The grace in the church and grace in the kingdom it's different. It's different. Hallelujah. We should let the grace of God build us, strengthen us, help us to work on what the Lord wants us to become. Let those who have an ear, let them hear. Hallelujah. Okay, next. Okay, next. If you are in the church realm, you are man-like. The church order, you have man ministry, the ministry of Ephesians 4:11. The Ephesians 4:11, they made it to become the leader's option to follow them. Okay? The leader will train this, and you will see. Every member, every congregation will become like the leader. But if you begin to move in the kingdom, you will become God-like. Ephesians 4:11 is a very powerful aspect. That if every one of us, will move with the pastor, teacher, evangelist, prophet, apostle, giftings, and move as one, this is a government that will help the congregation to become what the Lord intended them to be. Church is man-like. Kingdom is God-like. Okay, here's another one. In the church age, you have sacrifices and sacrificial giving. In the kingdom, there is a sacrificing. You minister life at all times, realizing none is yours and all is His. Okay? In the kingdom, you move in the freedom of worship, in the freedom of service. You don't expect for appreciation. You don't expect for rewards, although God will reward you. That is how the kingdom works. You cannot see in the Bible that God will thank you. You cannot see that one in the Bible, that God will thank you. God never thanks us, because God rewards us. He loves to reward you every time you work on your prescribed design. Look at Adam. Adam didn't ask for anything, and when he worked on his design, God rewarded him. Hallelujah. Okay, let's go to another one. In the church order, you are trying to die to self. But in the kingdom order, you give life, realizing you were crucified with Him. In the church order, you try to live in the physical aspect, because you don't know the spirit. Although your thoughts are a spirit, you always perform everything by the flesh. That's why you want to fast for how many days? You want to read the Bible and sacrifice yourself with it? You want to serve in the ministry and do everything so that you will die to self. That's the thing with the church. But in the kingdom, you give your life. You give your life generally. Because you thought, you know, you were crucified with Him. As the Bible says, I am crucified with Christ. I am crucified with Christ. And I no longer live. The life I live in this body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loves me and gave Himself for me. So in the kingdom, you do this supernaturally natural. You live supernaturally natural. You're not being pushed to. But you are natural in serving. You are natural in loving people, in understanding people, in caring for people, because you already receive the manifestation of God's Spirit who has the fruit inside of you. Hallelujah. Although my gums is hurting, but okay, I'm enjoying. Hallelujah. Next, the church has their eyes continually on the self nature. The church has their eyes continually on the self nature. But the kingdom looks only on him and the life. Okay? So you can see in the church, a lot of people in the church, they always protect themselves. They always protect their position. They always protect their, their name. They always protect that. But in the kingdom, you look only on him and the life. You just give everything. Your protection is on him. When you serve, you will really serve. When you love, you will really love. When you have self-control, you have self-control. The Bible says, with all of this, there is no law. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control. The Bible says in Galatians, with all of this, there is no law. The laws cannot be affected by the fruit. The fruit is the character of God. If you love, really love. If they do bad to you, at least you love them. Love them. Your loving to other people doesn't depend on what they do to you. Your love for other people is not dependent on whether you can get something for them or not. Yes, let go and go with the flow. Yes, hallelujah. So when you love, really love, whatever they do to you, oh, it doesn't matter. It's this. I love you. I love you. I love you. Hallelujah. So in the fruit of the Spirit, there is no law. Hallelujah. And so next. The church age has the word. The church age has the word. But it says that the kingdom has the power in 1 Corinthians 4:10. The word will bring conviction, but the kingdom is what will bring the change. Now, I've been reading this. They've been telling about the personal revelation. If your personal revelation is not based on the Bible, you are in danger. Everything should be based on the Bible. You know what? There are no such thing as personal revelation. There are no such thing as personal revelation. All revelation came from the Father. Remember when Jesus asked Peter, who do you think I am? And Peter says, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus is asking him. But Peter pointed Jesus that he is the Christ. He didn't point, you are Jesus, the Son. No. He specifically said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus Christ said, Peter, these things was not given to you by any man, but it was given to you by my Father in heaven. Revelation comes from the Father. It was given for the purpose of realizing the truth, the righteousness, the plan and passion of God for us to understand. Hallelujah. You should understand that. You should understand those words. So the church has always been with the word. They are always strict with the word, which is, it's okay. But the problem with the church is this. Every time they preach the word, they only repeat what the word says. They cannot say anything about the word. Hallelujah. But in the kingdom will give you the manifestation, the revelation of the word. I remember when God gave me the revelation of the John 3:16, for God so loved the world, it didn't say for God so loved men. So God is speaking about the world that He loves, not men. God loves the world. Why? The Lord first created the world, brought the kingdom on this world before He created men. The world is very important with God, because it is in this world, on earth, where God has extended His kingdom. Look at this word, for God. The word for, it speaks about in accordance, in obedience, based on. That is only the word for. The word for is a government word. It is not only an adjective or whatever. Based on the condition of God, for God, based on the condition, based on the aspect of God, who dearly, who devotedly, who gave His all to this world. That's what it says. So the kingdom will give you the manifestation of the revelation that comes from God. God the Father will give you a clear understanding of what He is saying. He is not only here for you to repeat the words. He is here for you to tell you, the excitement of this word. That's why Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. I respect them when they on how they properly interpret the Bible. Okay? But right now, we are not interpreting the Bible. We are getting revelations from God about what He has said. That's very different. Okay? For God so loved the world. Okay? So in abeyance, based on the purpose of God, who dearly so loved the world, because He has chosen the world where He will extend His heaven, that he gave His begotten Son, hallelujah, that He gave His only begotten Son to seek and save that which was lost. Because the Father knew that even man will be saved unless man will find what was lost, man will be incomplete. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes on the Son, Bible says, if you continue in My word, you will receive knowledge. Whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, shall not bring into decay, to death, but will have eternal life, or the life of the divine, for earth right now. That's what you call revelation. And I pray, and I will pray, that you will also receive these things. Hello, Sister Loretta. You will also receive these revelations from those words, from those popular verses that you have. I decree that. I decree it right now. As you hunger for the Word of God, you will receive revelations after revelations from our Father God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And next, the church has meat and drink. Hello, Sister Esther from San Pablo. The church has meat and drink. It represents natural inclinations for the carnal man. But the kingdom has righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. The kingdom is only concerned with the spiritual man. So the church always speaks about the meat and drinks, the natural things. That's what the church right now is. So they've been speaking, if we have this material financial blessing, God is with you. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. There's a lot of people, even unbelievers, who has a much, much bigger assets. But God is up with them. But the kingdom has righteousness, peace, and joy. This is the thing. In the kingdom, you will move in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. And the things of the natural will only be added to you so that you can use them for the expansion of the kingdom of God, for blessing of others as well. Okay? So let's go to the next. The church age ministry is continually preaching a corporate perfection which the church shall receive. Corporate. But the truth of the kingdom preaching is personal perfection. In the church, it's always corporate. The church loves group. It loves group, many. Oh, we are many. We are 100. We are 2,000. We are 5,000. The church loves it. Just love it. Remember when David counted his strength, his army's strength? God rebuked him. God punished him. And as I keep on saying, if Jesus' concern is the number, it's the numbers, so he has a lot of followers. But Jesus only focused on the few, on the 12, on the 120. Supposedly that's 500, but only 120. Okay? So, God, the kingdom, is about a personal perfection. Personal perfection po. Hindi po corporate. It will be hard for you to become perfect in the Lord as you see everybody na dapat sabay-sabay kayo. No, it will not happen. God wants you to have a personal perfection, not a corporate. So each one of us should have a very intimate personal touch with our God. Hallelujah. Another. What time is it? The church age says that you are part of the body of Christ. But the sons of God are not part of the body of Christ. They are part of his headship. The kingdom is a headship company, but the church is the body of believers. Why is this? Because the kingdom works. We work with the king. We work with the king. We don't work with the body. The church works with the body. This is what's happening right now. The pastoral movement, the body of Christ, they work together as a body. Hallelujah. They are working for the head. You cannot do that. You cannot work yourself in the service of the head. No. The head always gives instruction to the body. The body cannot serve the head. It is the head that gives instruction whatsoever to the body. The kingdom is a headship company. We work with the body. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please listen to this again. Listen to this teaching again. Okay, the kingdom nature is putting on the nature of God and the fruit of the Holy Spirit. The kingdom is living in the third heavens. Whereas the church in the second heavens fighting the enemy all the time. Here's another difference. The church is fighting always in the second heaven. The second heaven. And Jesus name, in the second heaven. They worship together. destroying the works of the enemy in the second heaven. But the kingdom, hello, Brother Joe. But the kingdom, we work with the third heavens. That's the difference. It's a big difference. The church is working in the second heaven, fighting with the enemy. But the kingdom is working under the third heaven. We are working under God to fight the enemy and destroy the enemy here. Big difference. Big. Big difference. Very, very big difference. Next. The church age is doctrine led. The church uses the gifts to bless the fleshmen, always wanting the anointing to come down. The kingdom age is principle led. The kingdom person does not want rain. He wants a river to flow out of him. That's what the kingdom is. That's what the kingdom is. I remember the ox that flew in the river. The story. I don't know if it's Elijah or Elisha. When the ox flew in the river, and the boy cried because he only borrowed the ox. Suddenly the man of God came, and the man of God saw that he was crying, and he told him, "Oh, my ox, the ox head has been in the river. I don't know how to get it." And what did the prophet do? So the prophet asked him to get a little wood in the tree and throw it to the river. And when he threw the wood in the river, suddenly the ox, the metal, the steel ox, floated on the water. And I told to my friend, you know what? There's another story for that God will do to us. There's another story for that God will do to us. The same thing. The ox was thrown to the river and it's down. And what will I tell them? Okay, get a wood and throw it to the river. And you know what will happen? What will happen? The ox will never float. You know what will happen? The water will be sit by the wood. Instead of seeing the ox floating, you will see everything that is hidden under the river. That is the new dimension that God will give us. That's the new dimension, the new wave, the new season that God will give us. The wood will sip, will drink everything in the river. And and the riverbed will show everything that is in that bed. Hallelujah. Will you please say amen? Hello, Brother Chris. Okay. Hallelujah. Here's another thing. It's almost done. Those in the church lives in their bodies but do not reside in Christ in their bodies. Those of the kingdom are living in spiritual realm. They are living in Christ, the Most High God. The same thing that I mentioned earlier. Hallelujah. Okay. There's a lot more that I can share to you, okay? But I'm limiting my teaching for 1.5 at least, because actually we can continue this tomorrow. Tomorrow is Sunday. I'll be teaching about the dimensions in God's kingdom. Okay, so again, please, it's in the Facebook. If you have time, here, always here. Repeat the message until you get the revelations after revelations after revelations. You know what? When I hear one message, when I hear just one word, I stop and I begin to dwell in that word, and God brings me a lot of revelations. So, faith cometh by hearing and hearing and hearing by the word of God. Okay? So you have seen the pattern. In the kingdom of God. The pattern in the government of God. There is a lot of difference between the church age and the kingdom of God. So again, we are not on the end time. End time has already started 2,000 years ago. We are now in the days of the kings. We have entered the days of the kings. So I will deliver that on April 26 as the final message of our Master's Teaching Series. Okay? And please pray for this. I'll be also doing a Tagalog teaching on the Mothers of the Kingdom so that our Filipino brothers will also understand the Tagalog words. So, again, I've already posted the 10 teachings, the first 10 teachings on my YouTube channel. So, please go to my YouTube channel, subscribe, and tell it to your friends, ask it to your friends, so that many of them will learn about the message of the kingdom. Okay? So, again, thank you for your time, and thank God, because I passed this time having a pain here. Oh, bless God. Father, thank you once again for this time that you have given us. Thank you for your words. Thank you for your revelations. Lots of it, oh God. And I decree that your revelations will continually touch us. Touch your people, oh God. Transformed our life, oh God. And we will be led in the Spirit. We will live in the Spirit. We will work by the Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you. I decree that you will continually speak to your people. Thank you, God, for your beauty. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Lord God, for your power. Thank you for giving us all of these things. We honor you. And we continually pray, oh God, for the approval of Fabunan injection by the FDA in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name. And we decree, Lord God, for the approval of our president, for your protection, for your strength, for your wisdom upon him. Thank you, God. We decree healing in the global community as we decree for the COVID-19 to be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Oh, God, thank you. We honor you. We bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Bye-bye. Thank you once again.